Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Semyon Alapin and Johannes Medga. This game was played in Breslau in 1889. Alapin had white pieces and he started with e4. Medga played e5. Bishop to c4, the bishop's opening, maybe. Knight to f6, attacking the pawn on e4, defending. Bishop to c5, knight to c3. d6. White to move. Alapin would like to play the Vienna game. f4 move. But black dark square bishop is discouraging it. So we have knight to a4, hunting the bishop. Bishop to b4, check. c3. Bishop to a5, b4. Bishop to b6, and now knight takes on b6. The bishop did not escape the destiny. A takes on b6, and now f4 as planned. Knight to c6, knight to f3, and both players castled kingside. Bishop to g4, pinning the knight, asking a question. Bishop takes knight, queen takes bishop, and white has a bishop pair. Black to move, pawn takes pawn on f4 was played. If queen to e7, then f5. And then g4 and so on. Back to our game. Pawn takes pawn on f4. Bishop takes on f4. And I already mentioned that white has a bishop pair. But now, knight to e5. Attacking the queen. A decision time. Which bishop to keep? What would you do in this position if you had white pieces? Alapin decided to keep the light squared bishop. So he played bishop takes on e5. Let's take it back. If queen to e3, then knight takes on c4, and after d takes on c4, black is standing slightly better, believe it or not. Back to our game. Bishop takes on e5. Pawn takes bishop. Queen to g3, lining the queen with the black king. Queen to d6, rook to f5, intending rook from a to f1, rook from a to e8, rook from a to f1, king to h8, king to h1. Just in case to avoid surprise checks, and black can't do much anyway. Rook to e7, queen to h4. Medga, player with the black pieces, was feeling very uncomfortable. He was thinking for a long time and played queen to d7. Let's take it back. The analysis after the game had shown that knight to g8 would offer the best resistance. This allows white to take on f7 now, but most probably Alapin would continue with g4 and g5. Back to our game. Medga considered many ideas and didn't like any of them, and then he played queen to d7. And he even didn't analyze this variation very deeply. It is white to move. What would you do? Please pause and find the best move for white. There is a move that is asking to be played, and that is rook takes on f6, removing the best defender of the black king. After some heavy thinking, Medga played b5. Let's take it back. If pawn takes rook, then queen takes pawn, check. And after king to g8, rook to f3, and black pieces are ready for another game. Back to our game. b5, attacking the bishop. What is the best square for the bishop? What would you do? Are you ready to see the move? Alapin played rook to h6. An amazing move, isn't it? Medga resigned. In view of discontinuation, pawn takes rook, queen to f6, check, king to g8, rook to f3, and there is no sensible defense against rook to g3, check. What a brilliant game by Alapin. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess. And bye for now.